So as the lights are still down and we await the start of Game 7 of the Turner Cup Finals, the game was set to have begun by now, but because of a pre-game brouhaha, as the teams were leaving the ice at the end of the warm-up, the game has been delayed, and we're going to take a further look now at what took place. It began between Wendell Young and Andy Bezo and escalated from there, Mike.
Well, Andy Bezo was down right where you see him, and then Wendell Young, and then Phil Crow came out on the ice. That's Phil Crow right there, and then there on all the guys just kind of started pushing and shoving. The guys started spilling out of the locker rooms then, and the man in black there, that's John Blum, assistant coach, then the assistant coach Rich Crom on the other side for Chicago, and eventually you have so many guys out there that it's really hard to stop, and you just have to hope that the players stop themselves, which they eventually did as well when Kevin McGuire came out onto the ice and started shooing guys back to the locker room.
Well, Doug Berhalt was out there for Chicago. He hasn't played in the series as yet. I believe that was Marinucci who was underneath Brad Norton.
Everybody set. The Wolves win the faceoff, and we're underway here in Game 7. Now Kuzmanov left corner. Kuzmanov holds onto it, gets a pick near circle. Kuzmanov left of the net. Kuzmanov back of the net. Oh, he got jammed against the wall by Choice. He's going to be okay, I believe. But if you make them play defense, that's when they are at their weakest. And Kuzmanov, Marinucci and Baker picking up right where they left off in Game 6, working hard down low, and it generated the Wolves' third goal on Friday night. High slot now, C-Mac fires it behind the net. Reese falls on it, and we get a stop and play. And now Savaglia and C-Mac have words. C-Mac has already gone off for unsportsmanlike. But he just goes to get his stick. Martins will give it to him as we face it off in the far circle. 2:03 remains in the first. We're scoreless. And the Wolves, with the benefit of the last change, put out Baker, Kuzmanov, and Marinucci. But it hits somebody's near corner. Bezo. Finished by Popvin in the left corner. Back of the net now. Baker up the far side. Baker sidesteps some of the traffic. Off the inboards. He'll reverse it over to the near side. Popvin. Flipped it ahead, and we're going to have a penalty here on Podman as he got the stick up on Bezo. That's what Bezo will do for you. Bezo was running right at Mark Podman, and Podman, after he delivered the shot up ice, went to protect himself. And we get a cross check on Potsy. Boy, if he got him with one, it was a real short one. Boy, if they score here, this would be almost exactly like Game 6. Choice. Marinucci had it stripped. Martin couldn't catch up with it. Here's Bezo. Skitters over the line. Took a hit from Millimar. Far corner now. Martin stands up. His guy back of the net. Bezo. Took a hit from Millimar. Flips it in. Near corner. Tilly. Avoids the hit from Bezo, who went head first against the boards, but he's fine. But he went straight for Tom Tilly. Tilly doesn't even go for the puck. And Bezo just went hammering into the left corner boards. Pearson, center circle, C-Mac over the line, high slot. A drop to himself. Centers, back of the net, Pearson. Pearson taken down. Far corner now, Martins has C-Mac out in front. Oh, he didn't see him. Center, Pearson, off the side of the net. And now we have Presley and Pearson going tooth and nail in front of the net. The spotlight went on, and Kevin McGuire raised his hand, but I believe that one went off the side of the net. Presley and Pearson just going crazy in front. Presley came in. Martins had C-Mac out in front. Pearson then fired. It went off the side of the net. Podvin went to celebrate. He thought it went in. And then Pearson threw the hands right in Presley's face, and then Presley threw a right. And now Ian Herbers is going to have to head off at least to get some repairs. He's got some blood. And we'll see what gets called here. It's Herbers heads off. Eye slot Nardella. Nardella moves up. Over the red line, over the blue line, left side. Nardella walks in, shoots, blocked. Rebound, far circle, Nardella centers. They score! Bob Nardella went to the far circle. After his shot was blocked, he centered it. Marinucci was right there, and he deflected it in. And the Chicago Wolves have taken a 1-0 lead in Game 7.
For Marinucci, his 7th of the playoffs. It goes 5-hole.
Center circle down. Over the red line, he'll drive it down low. Now C-Mac. C-Mac in the slot, right circle. Martin centers. C-Mac, he scores! Here in the Turner Cup playoffs, and they've been exceptional. High slot, Jay. Shoots Beauregard, a glove save on that knuckler. 9:25 left in regulation. 2-0 Wolves. An excellent skater. That's going to force Bobby J. or Ian Herbers to play beyond their capabilities to be an offensive factor. 6:53 remains in regulation. 2-0 Wolves. The Wolves, when they score the first goal, are 9-1. Far corner now, Martins. Oh, he couldn't get the puck out. Kessaw tripped up. Centered, and Carson denied by Beauregard. Tilly plays the body on Walker. Walker had it poke checked away. Far circle down to the high slot. Joyce shoots. Beauregard, a stick save. See, this is the problem when you play Andy Bezo. It shortens your bench incredibly. Nolimar chases it down behind his net. Pivots, throws it around to the near side, and Presley can't hold it in. Out at center ice, near side, Shaw pivots. Oh, he got hit in the back of the head by Pearson. Along the near side, we have a couple of guys fall on top of the puck and a stop. Jeremy Millamont. Oh, and now we have a little skirmish near side at center ice. Remember, this game started, in fact, before the game even started, we had a fight, a brawl, at the end of warm-up, instigated by Andy Bezo. Everybody came out of the locker rooms. Bezo was throwing punches. Dahl was throwing punches. Wendell Young came in and just hammered Rich Perron. 1:14 remains in regulation. Far corner now, Presley. Centers off the side of the net. Now back of the net, Kluche lost it. Near circle. Dahl golfs it into the air. Out the center ice. C-Mac is going to get this one in the slot. Shoots. He scores! A physical series, an intense series. And now, Breslin gets bumped by one of the Vipers as he begins to celebrate. Beddoes comes over to have a word with Breslin, as does Aldridge. All three of those guys went to Lake Superior. Breslin winning the national championship for the Lakers in 88. Aldridge is going to head off. I think they're going to call a penalty. Near side at center ice, Beddoes had it stripped. Gets it over the line. Near circle. Shoots. Goes behind the net. The crowd counts it down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The Chicago Wolves are the 1998 Turner Cup champions. Stefan Beauregard getting the
Chicago Wolves start the season with a shutout. They end the season with a shutout.
It is 847-498-6353. That's 847-498-6353 for JNC Ice Cream Sources and Catering.
Are you an investor or do you know 1982 and learn how to get your free stuff? Call 1-800-745-1982. That's 1-800-745-1982. You'll learn how to pop new idea and submit to industry. Call 1-800-745-1982. No way out. Wouldn't it be cool if you had a special button hidden away in your dashboard? A button that can make traffic disappear. A button that can remove all obstacles in your way. And now I'm getting down to show you that he's...
The Wolves captain will come out and accept. Malte kisses the cup and will now pass it around. First to one of the other captains, Tim Brezin. He's going to skate it around the ice. Nobody has left here in the building. Now to Mark Potvin. He celebrates his second championship, this one in the IHL. To Tom Tilly, who led all defensemen in the playoffs and scored more points from the blue line than anybody since 94-95. To Jamie Baker, his first ever championship. Chris Marinucci, his second. He's the guy who had the game winner tonight.
Of Federal Whaling will take exceptional care in the way they keep you in your possession, whether you're just moving around the block or to the other side of the globe. The pros at Federal Whaling are committed to your complete satisfaction. You can talk to one of Federal Whaling's certified moving consultants about your specific relocation needs. Call 1-800-373-2200.